I think in some variation or way, we had all kind of pitched something internally at some point where it was like, hey, there's a lot going on here. There's a lot going on with deployments. You know, we need to be able to make more sense of these things. And it just became really, really clear in practicing DevOps as it was evolving that there was a gap and that something was really missing.
Yeah, when would you say that you started, you had first had the idea for Sleuth?
It was definitely like on Bitbucket, probably like 3 years in or something like that, because we started looking at the pull request emails to like figure out what was going on. That wasn't working anymore. And all of a sudden Atlassian had grown such that I was getting stuff from up top saying like, hey, you guys are working in a different way. Is that working or is it not? And what are you shipping? And it became like kind of really crystal clear that like deployment is the moment that matters the most. And yet nothing was oriented around that, right? Like it was buried in CI/CD somewhere. It became clear that there's a big hole here.
The timing was interesting because Don and I had both left to go to another startup, and we had again seen the same challenges that we had gone through years earlier at Atlassian with the same thing of trying to move a company from more of a waterfall type delivery to more regular releases. And so again, there's no tooling around this. There's nothing that tells you if that's working or how well you're doing it. And we saw again, people writing scripts and, you know, sticking things together with, you know, tape and barbed wire to try to get some view and understanding across all the different systems of what's actually happening with your deployments. And is it improving the life of anybody that you're releasing more often?
The times when I would get excited was when I'd get into a Sleuth conversation, you know, with you or Michael or whoever it was, right? And then it would be like, oh, what about this? Or what about that? And like the shower thoughts never stopped, you know, and like all these kind of like dreams of like what it might look like.
So all these shower thoughts happened while you're at Atlassian, can't work on it. And then you finally decided to take the plunge and go full time on the startup that had previously made you $30 that 1 month.
That's right. It was like, wow, more and more people are moving to CI/CD. More and more people are doing frequent deploys. The state of DevOps reports are like saying all the things that we've been thinking for years.
When we left to start this, we were really focused on this idea and this problem around tracking deployments and recognizing there's all these different best of breed tools that go into it, but there's nothing that gives you the visibility across the entire arc as to what happens. And that was really what we were trying to solve for customers with an ultimate intent of really making it easier to move towards continuous delivery.
We want to help teams get better, deploy more, faster, safer. Tracking things was kind of step one. Step two that we're doing right now is to give you actual metrics, turning that tracking into metrics that are useful.
Hard metrics
that look at the speed, but also the safety.
Our intent was to help teams get better, right? Like we thoroughly believe that deploying frequently is an amazing practice. The whole industry is moving there. You know, fast forward many, many years and like you won't have teams not working in that way. But it's not an easy journey. And it's a journey that is filled with continuous learning, continuous experimentation in order to sort of get there and to improve. And I mean, we've talked to a million CTOs that say, I'm pretty tired of sitting in a boardroom and having the board like hit me with, what are you doing with that engineering allocation? You know, did it work or didn't it? Being able to really accurately glean that information of like, how is your efficiency and how are you doing? I think deployment tracking unlocks that. And that's definitely, you know, propelled us in the direction that we're going in. And there's so much more to that too. You know, having those hard metrics, like how can we just unlock the ability to do those experiments in zero time, you know, so they don't cost you anything and you can just continuously get better and better.